Hey, you guys here? Good. Welcome to Facebook Live. Welcome to this awesome discussion that I am so excited for. I really appreciate you carving out the time to show up for this. I don't think that you would have done it if you weren't at least a little bit interested in the topic at hand, and it is family history. We're going to talk about that. So I'm going to introduce myself briefly here in just a moment, but let me just tell you the big struggle, because I have a feeling many of you will relate to this. The big struggle that I've had, and many of you have had as well for a long time, is that when you are the very lucky recipient of family history pictures and you have that great opportunity to do something with them, how overwhelming is that feeling? Right? I mean, it is an overwhelming feeling, and it doesn't necessarily even have to do with the amount of pictures, which of course is the case for some of us, is the sheer amount of pictures that maybe you inherited in some way. But it's also that kind of, I don't know, that feeling of responsibility that it's on you to make sure that this is done right, right? Like these pictures are preserved and that they keep getting passed on through generations. And that's kind of a lot of pressure. And I bring that on myself. No one's asking me to do anything with family history, but it's something that I feel as a documenter, as a scrapbooker, as a lifelong storyteller, I feel that responsibility, and I know that many of you relate to that. And so the problem that I'm having with this overwhelming feeling is exactly what I want to talk today about. Not so much the problem, actually, but the solution. So the solution is something that, for me, has made so much sense. So this is my quick disclaimer. When I think about solutions, and I'm very solution-based in my life and in my work, I'm always thinking, like, what makes sense? What works? Why does this work? Let's do this better, right? When it comes to family history and scrapbooking or memory keeping in general, I have a very deep-rooted and strong belief that there's no one answer that fits everyone, right? One size fits all? No, that's not what I believe. I really believe that when it comes to documenting our memories and preserving our pictures, that there is a specific approach that's going to work differently for people based on their situations. And so that's the first thing I want to put out there, is this is not, what I'm going to share in this broadcast is not what I would say is the solution to all of your family history picture problems. But I am going to say that this is a solution that works for me, and I hope that it is something that works for you. I hope that by you being here, by you watching, and by you even contributing to the conversation, please feel free to chime in with questions or comments as you feel inspired to do. And that's what I want to talk about. It's not going to be the end-all, be-all, perfect solution for every single person watching, but I have a feeling it will resonate with some of you, okay? So really quick introduction, because we do have a lot of you here who are first-time viewers or visitors from elsewhere, right? Like you just heard about Facebook Live, you heard that I was on here, and I'm talking about family history. I'm also talking about chatbooks, which is part of my solution. So if you are new and you're less familiar with me and with our company and with this brand, so I'm Becky Higgins, and this company is Becky Higgins, LLC, and everything that we do ties back to cultivating a good life and recording it. That is at the core of everything that I believe in my work and everything that we do as a company. And so no matter what we're sharing, no matter what we're talking about, no matter what products we're producing, no matter what any of this, it is important to me that people feel inspired to cultivate a good life and record it. So that's the essence of who we are. But a really quick background, some of you go really far back in scrapbooking. So I'm going to dust the cobwebs out of your brain, right? So some of you will remember creating Keepsakes magazine. Does that sound familiar? So it was a magazine that popped up in the mid-90s, and I was a part of that magazine from almost the beginning, and I was their creative editor for 12 years. And so just to give you a history on my professional background, this is important to note, because I'm just not coming out of nowhere saying, hey, I've got this fun idea. I really have 20-plus years of industry experience and expertise and love. I started as a scrapbooker. I didn't come into this career out of nowhere. This is like running through my veins, and you'll find that out if you don't already know that about me. So I was the creative editor for Creating Keepsakes magazine for 12 years, and I actually published 9 books on the topic of scrapbooking. And fun fact, some of you may or may not know this, but I wrote a book called Family History Scrapbooking. What? I did that. So sometimes I forget that I did that. It's been exactly 10 years ago that I wrote that book. It was in 2006. I forgot to bring the book with me. Molly, do you see glare or anything, or is that okay?
It looks good.
Okay, so this is just the cover of the book, Family History Scrapbooking. So if you're wondering if this is something that I've cared about for a while, it very much is. I love family history, and I love scrapbooking. I love memory keeping of all kinds, and so that's what's bringing me here today. So I was a creative editor for Creating Case Takes magazine for 12 years, and then 7 years ago, I started this company to bring solutions to our scrapbooking marketplace and to you. And that's what I do, all right? So, but I'm not going to be talking a whole lot about my company or what we do in this broadcast. Interesting. I think that when it comes to scrapbooking and memory keeping, it's really important for people to realize that there are options. There are different approaches, and that's really a significant takeaway that I hope that you get from this. If you are already here, if you're already a project lifer and you are using our product, which is awesome, and you know how amazing it is for helping you preserve your memories and doing it quickly and easily, and you don't have to fuss with stuff, and it's a great system, right? I also want you to keep an open mind about some other options. Now, Chatbooks, which I'm going to be talking about here in a minute, has nothing to do with our company. We have nothing to do with their company. Chatbooks, did not ask me to do this. And I think that's important to point out. They've been awesome at spreading the word and sharing it with their customers to let them know, or you know, that I'm doing this broadcast, since I am, of course, talking about their product. But it's important to note that they didn't ask me to do this because I'm very unbiased in that respect. I really want people to find solutions that make sense for them. And if that means I point them in other directions for different reasons, I'm going to do it. So let's talk about family history, okay? Molly is here, and she's going to let me know if there are certain questions or comments that need to be interjected that are very relevant to the conversation. So even though I'm just talking kind of to myself, to you, but like a, you know, one-person conversation, it seems like, please know that you are more than welcome to join in, and let's talk about this. So I'm going to explain what the solution is, and if you feel like this is interesting to those other people in your life that you know, take pictures or have family history pictures or have an interest in preserving pictures, that's pretty much everybody you know, please share it. Please share this broadcast so that they can also gain some insights. All right, so let me just show you something really quick, okay? This is a basket. Can you see that? A basket of many baskets of family history pictures that I have. Now, it seems like I've done absolutely nothing, which of course is not the case. I've done some stuff, but I have... Oh, you should smell it. You should smell it. 1981 smells real good. I love that the dates are on some of these. I have so many family history pictures. And that kind of, I should explain my brief history of like what I've been doing all this time. Like for 20 years, I've been collecting and kind of gathering as many family history pictures as I can get my hands on, as many as my parents will let me kind of take and borrow or whatever. And in those 20 years, once in a while, I'll go on a scanning spree, and I'll just scan a bunch. And that brings me to like one of my favorite points ever, and that is that when it comes to family history and you receiving those pictures or having the ability to borrow them or whatever, my number one advice would be scan them. Okay, so if my house burned down tomorrow and this basket is in that house, those pictures are gone forever. Okay, the negatives don't exist on most of these or any of them, and they would be no longer. That is devastating. That thought is, it's devastating, and for, unfortunately for some people, it's a reality, right? Floods happen, fires happen, robberies happen, mistakes happen, spills happen. Things happen where pictures get ruined, and as important as it is to have things printed out, it's equally important to make sure that we have digital copies of them. So make sure that you are scanning your pictures as best you can. And I put everything in Dropbox. That's where I store my family history pictures. If you're not familiar with Dropbox, this whole conversation is not about Dropbox. Just go to dropbox.com, and it's basically cloud storage. Okay, it's awesome. You can share it with friends and family. They can add pictures. They can make changes, whatever. So I have all of my family history pictures set up in Dropbox, and I have it organized and categorized by person or by couple in the family. So my dad has his own folder. My mom has her own folder. Each of their parents has a folder, and so on and so forth. And anytime I get any sort of a picture that's scanned and sent to me by a family member, or I randomly come across something, or I get another basket of pictures or whatever, those are scanned and added to those folders. Okay, so that's like my number one thing is please do your very best to try to make that a project if you haven't done it already. Scan them, share them with your family, make sure they're backed up, because if anything happened to this physical basket of pictures, I know that they are at least safe and sound in digital format and of course can be reprinted again, okay? So that's my number one thing that I wanna make sure that you know. Now, as for the big, do you have something, Molly?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
How do you handle scanning large format old photos? This person has a 4-foot panoramic photo of a logging camp.
Ooh.
From her great-grandfather that she would love to scan.
Okay, that is such a great question. So she's asking about something that's like, scanning is great, right? I've got a basket full of little pictures. But if you have something that is large, there's, oh my goodness. Okay, so here, I have an answer, but I'm gonna ask you to check back for that. Here's the reason why. Is my husband and I have found, my husband is David, and he started this company with me, and he cares about this stuff too, especially the technology part of it. So that's David in a nutshell. So David and I have found this scanner that's actually for large format scanning. So it's not a little flatbed. It's not a little scanner that you put a pile of pictures in and scan it through, like the ScanSnap, which I love. We have it here at the office. We have it at home. It's not one of those. It's actually a scanner that is meant for larger things, okay? So the reason I'm saying check back is if you're following me on social media, Becky Higgins LLC. Molly's gonna take a note to make sure I don't forget this, is I will share a picture of that scanner and give you the information that you can look into that. Now, to answer, that answers part of the question. The other part of that question needs to be answered with this. When you're talking about things that are like 4 feet big, and I think that's what she said, right? It's like really large and print. That is where you take a photograph. You can't scan that. Not with technology that most of us have available at our fingertips, right? So if I have something large, it's 4 feet, or large of any size on the wall, I just need to take a camera, and even if it's your iPhone or some of these cell phones take amazing pictures. So just do that and take a really good still picture. Turn off your flash, get natural indirect light. That's what you want to do. And then you can have a really nice scan of that picture. Good question. Okay, so back to kind of this whole process. So you know the struggle, you know the issue, you know how I'm organizing my digital photos, and that's all great. Here's my epiphany. Ah, this is so good. So for me, what I've realized is I'm a professional scrapbooker. I'm an expert at memory keeping. I am a regular scrapbooker in my heart, in my soul, and on my phone, because I scrapbook using the project like that. I'm doing all these things, it's in my veins, you know that. Okay, so then I kind of had this realization last year, and I'm like, wow, I haven't actually done anything with family history pictures in years. So that basket that I showed you is just kind of sitting there, and it's all kind of sitting there. So thankfully, I have it all in one place in my home. I'm definitely chipping away at the organization of so much stuff, because like I said, I'm blessed to have a lot of things that I've accumulated and I've received. But at the same time, to me, it felt like this, I feel like my kids are getting older. My oldest is 13, our youngest is 7, turning 8, and they don't know a whole lot of our family history stories. Do you relate to this? Because I'm not sharing them. Once in a while, something will come up about grandpa, or once in a while, something will come up about an ancestor, and we'll share it. But there's not a whole lot that I've done that will actually keep the records of, you know, all of these unknown faces in these prints and these baskets, okay? So my epiphany. Enter Chatbooks. Chatbooks is a totally separate company from us. We're in the same marketplace, right? Like we're all helping people preserve their memories. There's lots of scrapbooking companies and photo preservation companies and companies that help with keeping pictures and memories, and that's all great. Chatbooks and we have very similar beliefs in that we want to help people hold what matters, right? That's like their tagline, hold what matters. And even though our approaches are so different, we believe at the core the same thing. We want people to have tangible memories. We want you to get memories or pictures off your phone, out of your drawers, and into something that you can hold, okay? So what is Chatbooks? Raise your hand if you know what Chatbooks is, okay? So some of you are already using Chatbooks or you've heard of it. So if you're less familiar, here's the brief way to describe what it is. It's basically the ability to take your social media account and have these little 6x6 books printed and sent to you. That's what it is. So really, it actually is not scrapbooking as far as like the action of, you know, of what it is. There's your effort is not actually putting anything together, and your effort isn't creating pages on your phone like you would be with a project like that. It's a very different but equally awesome approach to preserving your photos. And so the best way to learn about what Chatbooks is to go to chatbooks.com. They have a video called, I asked them, and it's called, watch the Chatbooks 101 video, go to YouTube. Okay, if you want to learn more about like how it works and all that, because this is not a technical conversation. I just want to speak at a really high level approach as to how I'm using it for family history. So the way Chatbooks works is you can take your account and set it up through the Chatbooks app, and they will send you every time you post 60 pictures, say on Instagram, it will automatically send you this little book. In fact, Molly, do you have the Chatbooks?
Yep.
And they will send them to you on a regular basis. They're like this. They're little, okay? So that's how it's set up. You can subscribe to it or not. You can make custom little books or not, whatever. There's a lot of flexibility with that. So that's what it is. Now, you do have the flexibility of printing Chatbooks, not just as an automatic feed of what your feed is. So for example, so on Instagram, I'm Becky Higgins, LLC. I'm regularly sharing work-related stuff, some personal stuff, some tips, some ideas. That's not the type of Chatbook that I need printed and sitting in my living room necessarily, but I do love, as many of you also, hashtags. So I have several hashtags that I set up in my sharing that make sense for me to have a little Chatbook printed. So for example, one of my hashtags is hashtag BH loves Arizona. That hashtag is meaningful for me because I was born and raised in Maryland. And then I now, for many years now, I've been an Arizona girl. This is where I live. It's where I'm raising my family and where I'm working, right? So this Arizona's home. So I've worked really hard over the years to love Arizona, to love the desert. And I truly do. So BH loves Arizona, the hashtag, guess what? Chatbooks will print your hashtag. Isn't that so cool? You want to see it? Want to see? These are my first three. Can you see those okay? First three Chatbooks that printed my hashtag BH loves Arizona. Okay, so enough about that. I just wanted to make sure you understood how that works. So back to my family history. Well, these are the printing of my Instagram account. So it's not Becky Higgins LLC. And this is my epiphany. This is like what just dawned on me last year, and I tried it and I'm sticking with it. And now I'm finally talking about it. And that is that I set up an Instagram handle that is very specific to my family history, meaning I have five brothers and me, our parents, grandparents, and so forth. Okay, so I'm not even talking about my husband's side of the family. That's another topic for another day. But I'm willing to do that. I just got to get there. All right, so we've got this little account. Now, here's the key. It's private. It doesn't have to be, but I'm just telling you, this little Instagram, if you went searching for it because you're interested and you want to follow, you're not actually going to because it's a private account. It's really only intended for our immediate family. Well, what's the point of doing that if I only have 20 followers, right? You see where I'm going with this? The point of it is that I always begin with the end in mind. Stephen Covey principle right there. I use it all the time in my life. Begin with the end in mind. Well, what does that mean for this? In my mind, the end result looks like this. So even though my problem is I'm so overwhelmed with family history and I don't know where to begin, my solution is this. Becky, you don't need to carry that responsibility of doing every single thing with every single picture and making sure you have every single detail of all of the family history pictures and the memories and everything and putting them in this huge encyclopedia set of family history books. You don't have to do that right now. I'm telling you, you don't have to do that right now. And so what makes me sleep better at night as a memory keeper is that all of my pictures are getting scanned and they're being in Dropbox so that they live there and I've got copies and everyone in my family has access to them. And this. Now, why does this make sense for me? I'll tell you why. the reason why so many of us stay away from family history, scrapbooking, or documenting or preserving of the photos is because we don't know where to begin. So here's another point of permission for you. Let it go. Don't worry about the chronology. Don't worry about being even through all the different branches of your family. Don't worry about which picture at which time. Don't worry about any of that. And that was my epiphany. As I said to myself, self, if you set up an Instagram account and about 3 or 4 times a week or whenever you have time, you just share any picture. That's the key. Any picture. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. That one. Right? That one. It doesn't matter. Whatever picture you just decide is like, you know what, that's a nice picture. I'm going to share that with my family. And so what I do is 3 or 4 times a week, sometimes it's every day, sometimes it's once a week if I get busy, but whatever, right? There's a schedule, no one's holding me to this, is I post a picture on Instagram. And what I do is I share the one picture, and if I don't know what's going on in that picture, I'm super fortunate that my parents are still living, I throw them a text. I send, they know this rhythm, we've got this down pretty good. So my mom and dad get a text from me with the picture. I don't even say anything, I don't ask anything, because they know what I'm doing. They know that I'm texting them a picture and I need them to share their insight or their information on what's going on. They send it back, I post it with that caption, and that's posted, okay? So let's take a quick question, I'm gonna keep going with this.
So someone's wondering, will that caption print with the picture in the book?
Great question, and it will. So Chatbooks allows you to remove the captions if you want, I think, I'm pretty sure. Remember, I'm not customer service, but I'm pretty sure that as a customer, I'm pretty sure that I've seen that option that you could turn them off. But the way I have these set up is that the captions are printed, and you can see that here, okay? So captions are printed with pictures. If the caption's too long, it goes to the next page, and that was a good one, hold on. And it shows it right there, okay? So so I text my parents, I ask them for a little information, I post it on Instagram. Now, let me tell you the twofold blessing that this is. Number one, those very few people that are following that account, my immediate family, my parents, my brothers, their wives, their children, right? And not even all of them follow it. Like some, there's a few family members that they're not interested. That's okay. I'm not making anybody care about this. But I do want to give them the opportunity to learn and gain insights and love our heritage, our family history, our ancestors, even our own childhood. So some of the pictures I post are from our childhood. In fact, the covers of both of these old chatbooks are from our childhood. That's my brothers and me and my parents and our parents. They can claim them too. All right, so so that's number one. That number one blessing that I see is that on a regular basis, my family members have the opportunity and my own, like my oldest son is now on Instagram, and so he's following it, and he's seen these glimpses that I'm sharing with these little fun facts or information or insights or whatever, okay? Number two, the second fold of the fold is that not only is it fun for them to see the glimpses on a regular basis, and I love sharing, and I hope that they enjoy seeing, but this is the second thing. We now have these tangible books. You guys, these are like $8. Very affordable, adorable, small, easy to hold in your hands. If something happens and the kids rip them or whatever, it's $8 to replace it. So you know what I did at Christmas last year? I printed a whole bunch, about 20, of these chatbooks, of the first volume. Which one is it? This one. I printed about 20 of these through chatbooks, $8 a pop. Actually, it might have been a little less at that point. And I sent them to each of our family members at Christmas time. Now, why does that matter? Because it's a physical, tangible thing to hold. Remember what I said about how everyone's not on social media? Well, hello. We have a lot of younger nieces and nephews that, of course, are too young for social media. So they're not even really seeing what I'm posting. But this is what they can hold in their hands and they can flip through. And guess what? Guess what, friends? The order doesn't matter. This is not a chronological look at the history of Aunt Hilda. And it's not going back to the 1840s of whatever. It's just a random picture. It's my brother from his childhood, and it is my great-great-grandmother, and then it's my two oldest brothers with their parents at the farm, and then it's old family history pictures, and it's my little brother sucking his thumb, falling asleep on the picnic chair. You see what I mean? So it's super random. It's never planned in advance, and it's just, It just is, right? It doesn't even matter the order. Okay, we've got another question.
So every time you print, does it pick right up with the last print? Does the next book pick up with the last picture?
Yes,
printed?
That's exactly how it works, the way I understand it. So when I printed volume one right here, Chatbooks automatically sent it to me because I set up my account with Chatbooks and I set it up with my account at and the family name, right? And so that's when I hit 60, because they print 60 in a book, when I hit 60, Chatbooks automatically printed this little gem, and I think I got an email notification from them saying, your book is ready. Do you want to make any changes? So that I then had a chance to go in and choose my cover and just make any changes if I needed to, which I don't think I even made changes. I was like, hey, whatever I posted is what I want, right? And then they shipped it. How cool is that? So then volume two started with the 61st picture that I posted, and then it went on and on. And the reason I only have two is because I only post a few times a week, and so I'm waiting for my next book, 60, to fill up. Okay, another question.
If people comment on the pictures in Instagram, those don't print on the chatbooks,
correct? You can turn, I don't even know if you can turn the option of comments on, but as far as the default way that it's set up for chatbooks, it's not printing any of the comments. It's printing the captions. Now, that is a good question for this family history angle, is if you wanted the comments to show up because you want everyone's feedback and, oh, I remember when, and reminiscing about those old times, that's a great question for customer service, which, by the way, write this down, and then I'm going to take another question. support@chatbooks.com. I'm not customer service. I don't work for Chatbooks. I'm not affiliated with them. I love their product and I think it's great. So make sure if you have questions like that, that you take it to support@chatbooks.com. So we've got a little bit more, so stick with me. What's another question?
Someone asked if you can also print your pictures from Facebook.
Yes, it does connect with Facebook as well. The way that I understand it, and Molly, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure they'll print your Instagram account. But it also works with Facebook. It even works with your camera roll.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you wanted to heart or, you know, how you favorite pictures in your camera roll, it will even create books like that. It doesn't have to be on social media, right? Like they're genius. It's so cool. It's really cool. Okay, so I think I've explained the general process for what I do and why I do it. And I hope that you can kind of see why this makes sense for me, why I love it, how we can as a family benefit from seeing these pictures and stories. And I also want you to feel the permission that it doesn't have to be the entire collection of family history pictures that you have, right? Just kind of curate the best stuff. It doesn't have to be everything that you have, and it doesn't have to be in a specific order, and it doesn't have to be chronological. It just doesn't have to be. And that was my big epiphany, is realizing that it doesn't have to be what my OCD tendency brain wants to do, right? Like I want to have this like library and all these albums full. It doesn't have to be that way. All right, Molly, what else?
So if you don't know any details about a photo, do you leave it out or would you maybe still put a photo in if you know nothing about it?
That's a great question. So I, you know, this is funny that I brought this one up earlier because I don't even know who this is. It says Carol on the back. It was probably one of my grandmother's friends. It's not a picture that is of value to our family, probably, unless we know who Carol was, right? And so if your parents or grandparents or aunts, uncles, living relatives are alive, when it comes to family history, this is such a generic, broad kind of overview statement, but really, like, take advantage of that time to ask the questions. If you have questions about pictures that you came across, documents, anything like that, please ask the people who might know. If truly nobody knows, then if you found a picture that you know is someone in the family but you don't know who, in my opinion, and that's what I think you're asking, I would share it, right? Like if this is an unknown member of our family, it looks like he served in World War One. We don't know anything else, but we can honor him, right? I'm not sure I have another opinion other than it's okay to share ones like that once in a while. But for some of these, you know, there's a picture of I'm just literally pulling this off the top. There's a picture of a dog. If we don't know who that dog is, and actually, I think I do know who that is, but it's Pumpkin. Pumpkin Hooter Tooter is the full name. But anyway, but if we don't know who this dog is, I'm probably not going to share it. All right, another question.
Someone who joined later in the broadcast is wondering how you deal with the pictures. What scanner do you use? If you want to go over that one more time.
Yeah, so, you know, I'm actually not going to go into too much detail on that. And the reason why is because I don't want to mess up on the information that I share. So please make sure that you're doing two things, okay? And then this is how you're going to get your answer. If you're following me on social media, Becky Higgins LLC, and that's Instagram or Facebook especially, and if you are subscribing to our emails, BeckyHiggins.com/subscribe. Those are the two ways that I'm going to make sure that I answer that question. I want you to receive the answer to that question. I can tell you, scan, snap, I like that, but there's a specific model, but I don't remember which one it is. I want to tell you about that big scanner. I'm happy to answer those questions, and I want you to make sure that you get the answer. And it makes sense for me to share a picture of it, right? That probably makes the most sense and tell you more details. The other answer to that question is, for 1 hour after this broadcast, like literally as soon as we hit stop and I'm done and I'm not in front of the camera, I'm going to go sit at my desk and I'm going to have a conversation with you guys right here on Facebook. I'm going to answer as many questions as I can. And so if you have follow-up questions that you think I might be able to answer on social media, remember, some of your questions are going to be way, way, way too big and way too loaded, and there's no way that I can answer them on social media, because social media is about short and sweet answers. But please stick around, and I would be happy to answer some of those as well. Okay, Molly?
This is a question I think a lot of people have. What do you do with the original photos after you scan them, and especially if they're different sizes and materials and whatnot?
That's a good question as well. So there are different approaches to doing that. As far as, I hope you can hear Molly's question, but I think you can, but as far as once they're scanned, for me, once they're scanned, it's like, man, I don't even mind if these pictures end up at my uncle's house or if somebody else wants them, that's fine. I really feel that way, because then with those scanned images, I can print whatever I want, whenever I want, whatever size I want, and I can do something with them, right? And I love that. And that's where Project Life really comes in, for the physical, tangible scrapbooking and being able to slip photos into albums and all that stuff. But it's a very subjective topic. If you have an opinion about that, I would like for you to chime in. I would like for you to engage in that conversation, because everyone will have a different opinion. Here are just a couple of thoughts. Thought number one, I could take this basket of pictures sitting right beside me right now, and if I scan them all, and I know they're backed up and they're good, and I don't want to throw them away, Project Life is absolutely the solution. So if you're less familiar with Project Life because you're new here, the whole system is pocket scrapbooking. It's literally taking page protectors that are divided, and you slip those photos into pockets, and that's it. Like, you don't have to embellish anything. You don't even have to do any decorating or designing of any kind. You just slip things into pockets, and it's done. That's why Project Life is resonating so well with so many people around the world. Now, odd size photos and how you handle that, like this right here, is definitely, these are odd size photos. This is not a 4x6, and a lot of you have pictures like this. What I would recommend on doing with that is you actually put a full size 4x6 or 3x4 card behind it. Even we have little boxes of white, plain white cards, and you just put that behind it. You don't even have to use adhesive, and you slip that into the pocket. Otherwise, it's going to be loose. Someone once asked us, let me change that. Many people have asked us in the past if we can make Project Life pages and pocket sizes for these odd size photos. The answer is no, and I'll tell you why. I did the research. We did the research. We looked at every size that ever existed, and holy cow, there are so many odd sizes. We are thankfully in the days of 4x6, like that's the standard size pretty much around the globe. But when you go back generations or decades, there's some odd size photos. So there's no way that we can accommodate the exact pocket size for all of those sizes, because there are truly more than you can even realize. So great question though. Was there something else, Molly?
No.
Okay. Okay, so I've explained the whole thing. Got a couple of little notes that I want to let you know about. Molly, will you hand me, yep, 2x8 album. Okay, so for those of you who have heard about Project Life and you're not sure what the Project Life app is, I think it's worth just mentioning that really quick, because Chatbooks is an app. They have taken the awesomeness of technology with social media and kind of bring it together to give you an end result like this. And it makes so much sense for a lot of reasons. One of them I just spent time sharing with family history. Another way that you can actually get your memories preserved is through the Project Life app. And it is available for iOS and Android, and literally it is scrapbooking in the palm of your hand. So this is really a good fit for people who do want to bring their memories together. It's not about social media. It's not about creating which photos. It's more of saying, I want to make some scrapbooks or some scrapbook pages, and I want to do it in the convenience of the palm of my hand. I want to lay in bed and do it. I want to do it on the airplane. I want to do it on the train. These are all great ways that you can do it. So the end result for that when you're using the Project Life app is in a couple different ways. So this is an example of our family yearbook. And every week I would have a layout that is our family's memories. Now, this makes so much sense for me right now in this format, instead of chatbooks for this type of thing, because on Instagram, I'm not sharing a lot of personal stuff, really, like ever. Like anything that I share that's on a more personal anecdotal note is something I know is publicly going to be seen. This is all of our personal family memories. And I created all these pages using the app, and I have printed them. And you order prints through the app, and these pages literally come as photographic prints. This happens to be the 8x8 size. We also have 12x12. And then you slip them into page protectors, which then go into binders. Okay, that's basically the essence of Project Life and the app format. And you can learn more on BeckyHiggins.com. You can go to the Becky Higgins YouTube channel and see an overview called Welcome to Project Life, which gives you a good look at the physical product as well as digital and the app. But one thing that has never really been shown before, and I'm going to leave you guys with this little treat, is that the Project Life app is also going to be available in the format of photo books. So if you are interested in printing your pages and slipping them into page protectors that go into an album, if you want more of the thin book, which is, again, one of the things that I love about chatbooks as well, is they're so little and easy to hold. We are so excited that we've been working really, really hard on bringing the photo book option to the app. It is something that we've been working on for a long time. We wish it were ready yesterday, right? Everybody wishes it was ready yesterday. But we are getting very close. It's happening this fall that these books are going to be launched. We don't have the exact date. That's impossible to announce at this point, but it is this fall. So just to give you a little sneak peek, a little preview, I'm not going to go through all of the options. This broadcast isn't even about this, but I thought this would be a fun little bonus at the end of this broadcast to let you know that the photo books are getting close and they're coming. So, but it will be like this, and it is flat lay. Right? So these pages will lay completely flat. Can you see that okay, Molly?
Yep.
Okay. Isn't that cool? So they don't even bow up. And you guys, the quality is unreal. This is a truly premium, classy product. We will be offering it in three different sizes to start. So this right here is 8x8, and this is 10x10, and this is 12x12. So you have options. And I'm telling you, it's just absolutely gorgeous. So that's just a little sneak peek at these. And you can feel the covers.
Someone asked if they come in hardcover. They're only hardcover.
Yeah, this is only hardcover. This is a very hardcover. Now, you might be asking about chatbooks. And let me bounce back to that for a minute, if you don't mind taking these. So chatbooks is, as you can see here, a soft cover. Can you see how different the products are, right? Like, that's why Project Life and chatbooks, we're achieving a very similar goal, but we have very different products and very different ways of helping people. And yet, in my opinion, they complement each other so well. But Chatbooks is available as a soft cover, as a default. But if you were to pay $5 more, my understanding is that Chatbooks will give you that option to have a hardbound, which is awesome. Really cool. I love that Chatbooks makes that an option. Okay, so one more bonus thing before we go here in just a minute is I want to give you a code. Do you want to try Chatbooks for free? Because I think that's the best way to do this. And again, I have to just tell you, if you missed the beginning part of this, Chatbooks did not ask me to do this broadcast. They never asked me to even share about them. I've paid for my books. This is none of that. It's not sponsored. It's none of that. I just think that they have a great product. And so I want to just publicly thank Chatbooks, not only for being awesome and having a shared passion that I do, but I'm so thankful that they were happy to share this with their audience and that so many of you are here because you are a Chatbooks customer. And so for those of you who are newer to Chatbooks and you would like to try, one of those for free, I have a code for you. So get your pen out. You're going to write this down. It's really complicated. It's not. Becky H. That's it. BECKYH. That is the code. So what you're going to do is you're going to download the Chatbooks app. You're going to set it up and give it a try. I'm not going to walk you through what to do because it's intuitive, just like the Project Life app. You just get it. You start, you know, poking around, you start tapping, and you'll see how easy it is. And then when it's time to order your first book, you put in that code, Becky H, and that is it. Then they will deliver a free chatbook to your front door. How fun is that? Thank you, Chatbooks, for that code, for my audience. I love my customers. Chatbooks knows that I love my customers, and they wanted to offer that to you, which is super cool. Okay, so again, if you have questions that are specific for Chatbooks, support@chatbooks.com is their customer service. I don't work for Chatbooks. I'm not their customer service. But if you have questions for me, I'm going to stay right here on Facebook for about an hour. I'm going to answer as many questions as possible. But I also want to point you to our YouTube channel, because on YouTube, you can actually see an overview that explains Project Life and understanding more about that. It's a very short and sweet and fun video. And we have a whole playlist that is for the Project Life app. So if you just kind of watch a few of those videos, it will all start clicking for you even before you buy the app, because you're going to see how it works. It's super easy, and so is the Chatbooks app. I think they're both just so great for different reasons. Make sure that if you go to BeckyHiggins.com/subscribe, we're going to make sure that you are filled in on all of the most important information and inspiration for cultivating a good life and recording it. And we're going to point you in the direction that you need for all of your photo preservation and memory keeping desires. All right, another question.
Do you know if Chatbooks is available for iPhone and Android?
Yeah, I think so. If you know the answer to that question, will you chime in? The question, Chatbooks available for both iOS and Android? I think so. I do not want to speak on their behalf, though, and I'm not exactly sure, but I have a feeling people are commenting right now, so you can look at that. I have one more little tip for you. If you want to get notifications, if you like this broadcast and you want to see more of our broadcasts, I think that the way that you can be notified when we go live is that you tap the live subscribe button at the top of our live video to get notified when we go live again. So that's a cool tip. I didn't even realize that, because I think that Facebook was still figuring out how they wanted to notify everyone. So I really do hope this was beneficial to you. I hope that you feel inspired to not be so stuck with your pictures, family history pictures specifically. It really can be daunting. I would never want anyone to think that that I don't relate to that. I completely do. You see how much undone work I have, right? There's a lot to do. And that's why I'm all about solutions. I really feel like that there just doesn't have to be this this idea that things have to be done a certain way when it comes to scrapbooking. That's just not the case. I think that it's important to keep our options open and to keep our minds open about different approaches. I am thankful that Chatbooks exist. They are absolutely a part of my epiphany for how I can do this in a way that it makes me sleep better at night and it's enjoyable for my family and beneficial for generations to come. I will continue to print these for my family as often as they happen, because they're really affordable. I'm also really grateful that we've been able to develop the Project Life system for another approach to preserving memories, particularly the Project Life app. And, you know, if you have other things that are working for you, this is an open discussion. Please chime in right here in the comments and let us know what's working for you. All right, Molly?
Someone asked to repeat the code, please.
Yes, the code, one more time, and then I'll go ahead and sign out. The code is, and this is to get a free chatbook to try it for yourself, is Becky H, BECKYH. All right, so are we good? You guys good? I hope this is helpful to you. Thank you again for being here, and we will see you next time. We'll catch you on Facebook Live whenever we do it again, whatever we're talking about. It'll have something to do with memory keeping. It'll have something to do with cultivating a good life and recording it. Anyway, thanks, you guys. We'll see you later.